I thought that at first I was like, hey, like, you know, you're not sorry because you did it, because if no one would have called you out, it would have been a continuous thing. You're sorry because you got caught.
Welcome to Queer Talk, the number one podcast to connect you to all of your favorite queer creators and a space where we share our stories on all things queer related. My name is Bree Walker, Bree Logan on all platforms. And if you're not listening to this on Apple Podcasts or on Spotify, you're not subscribed, what you doing, baby? Hit that subscribe button. And give us a follow on Spotify. We have a great guest on today. She's a TikToker, and she has got some tea on this Lundy situation. You can find her on Gabitron _ on TikTok and Gabitron on Instagram. Please welcome Gabrielle Lyon.
Hey, guys. How's it going? My name's Gabby. I just moved to the Tampa area about 3 years ago, originally from Virginia. I'm actually here now visiting on vacation, and I thought I'd take a moment to kind of speak on some current events and topics today.
Yeah, awesome. Hey, thanks for having you on. Super appreciate you coming on. I know that you've been traveling and stuff like that, so really excited that you were able to come on, be a guest, and talk to some of the LGBTQ plus community about what is going on with shit in this community and on TikTok. Cause like there is some crazy shit going on, and yeah, just wanted to bring you on to get your take on it.
Yeah. Shit's always hitting the fan in the LGBT community. Always some drama.
It is.
For sure.
So tell me a little bit about the Lundy situation, and I kind of just wanted to get it from your perspective, because your screenshot text was something that went viral in the community, and people were making a lot of content on it because it stirred up a lot of notoriety for the complete and total lack of I don't even know how to gather my thoughts on it, because it's something that makes me so angry. The things that have been happening with Michele Lundy and the things that she's been saying against people of color, and just the complete blatant racism that's happened, and it's finally rearing its head. It's something that I think that's been happening for a while now, and she's finally getting what I think she deserves for the complete and total lack of just... I can't speak. I literally can't speak on it. I'm like, I have no words for it. So what's your take on it, and how did you kind of get wrapped up in that?
So Michele Lundy is friends with some of my friends. One night we went out to have drinks, and some words that I didn't appreciate were being thrown around. And I kind of just let it slide because I was like, hey, I'm not going to sit here and start drama. I'm super laid back person. I don't like that drama shit. So not only were they being thrown around once or twice, but being repeatedly said. And at that point, I was like, okay, this is not okay. You have a person of the Caucasian descent saying these racist words, such as the N-word with a strong ER, mm-hmm. to someone who is of mixed descent. I'm biracial, so I'm both Black and white. Now, that being said, obviously, I'm still colored. I'm still part of the colored community. Mm-hmm. So I took serious offense to those words, you know, and
you
I did. Yeah, of course. And I called her out on it, and I was like, hey, like you can't keep doing this shit to people. Like, it's not okay for you to just treat people however you want to treat them and not be called out on it, especially because you're a public figure. One thing I had thought about earlier that I was saying that I actually read, it says, you get involved with the wrong people and it affects everyone around you. But having a platform on social media in this day and age exploits it to a tenfold. As I've had time to process this over the past week or so, I think to myself, where do I turn and what do I do next? I have spoken with Michele. I called her actually after all of this stuff blew up, after I had posted that and after she had deleted her Instagram because she's so upset about everything that's happening. It's not just a case of people calling her out on the blatant racism. It's now being taken into account of all the other things she's done over the past few years that are just not okay with people. And it took me to open that can of worms for all this other shit to come to the light.
Yeah.
And things that happen in the dark always come to the light, you know?
They do.
And it's like she has blatantly disrespected people time after time after time. And not just in racist ways, but other ways that are offensive to people. You can't just walk around with your nose up and talk shit to everyone and say things that you want to say without repercussion. So after all this happened, she actually did call me and she apologized. We talked on the phone for a little while. This girl drinks every night. I think she needs to get the help that she needs to get. And we all have issues, you know, but there's different ways to go about them. I pray for her, and I told her if she needs someone that will go to therapy with her or someone to sit with her and talk to her about these problems, I am more than willing to give a helping hand. I'm not that person. Like, it wasn't for the drama. Things just need to be brought to light.
Yeah.
I have a huge heart, and I will be there for anyone that needs the help. Even if I don't know you, reach out to me, you know?
Yeah.
So parts of me within me are trying to forgive her, and I am forgiving her for the things that she said, but it still doesn't excuse the things that have already been said. You have to take accountability for your words and actions.
I completely agree. Do you think that she's doing what she needs to do to make those amends? Do you feel like she could be on a path to that?
I believe that she can do better, and I hope that she does better for the sake of her and for everyone else around her. People love her, you know? She's fun to be around, but sometimes it just gets out of control.
Yeah.
I'm not going to talk so much shit about her because she's human and she does make mistakes just like everyone else, you know? And yeah, she went ahead and deleted her Instagram. She deleted her TikTok. Those could be the steps that she's trying to take to now try to get better. With deleting social media, she doesn't have to see it every day. True. Or she's avoiding it. Who knows? It could be on both sides of the spectrum.
True.
So I can't really tell you on that side, just from what I see as being an outsider. Deleting her TikTok. She's trying to stay away from the social media. Again, I don't know if it's because all the smoke she's getting or if she genuinely is trying to take the steps towards change.
And I think it's something that we'll find out, you know, with time. We'll see, like, is she taking a step back to grow and educate and learn and rebuild, you know? Mm. Or is it something where she's cowering and running away? And I think time will tell for that. Has she always kind of, because like what I've seen like on Twitter and things like that, like it's something that seems like it's been pretty continuous and pervasive, and she's had a lot of haters that have come out and been like, oh, I already knew that. Like, I've seen so many comments, like, I never liked her, I already knew this, stuff like that. Has it been something that's always been like that and it's just finally rearing its head? Or like, what's your kind of perspective on who she was before this?
So I've only known Michele for about three or four months now. Since I've known her, she's been living life on the edge for sure. Maybe she's just going through something. I can't speak on that, and I don't want to put her private business out there like that.
Oh, for sure.
So that's not something I can really speak on.
Okay.
From what I've been told from her really close friends is that when she's not drinking and she's just around them, she's a completely different person. She's sweet. She's not big-headed. She doesn't act the way she does as the way she portrays herself to social media. I followed Michele for a couple of years now, and I never really saw it before, actually. Like, in her videos and stuff with, like, Cheyenne, her ex, like, she kind of seemed like she was down to earth and grounded. It wasn't till they broke up that I think everything just went up in flames.
Yeah.
And that might be because of her breakup. I don't know. I can't speak on that again. I'm trying to be as even-sided as I can. So that's my input on that.
Gotcha. And breakups are hard. I mean, I think they had been together for a hot second. So like, I can definitely, you know, speak on that to just having a breakup that, you know, takes it. When you're in love with somebody, it takes months. Even if you're the one that breaks up with somebody, it takes months to get back to normal. And everyone has that where you're newly single and you're going out and you're like having fun. Maybe there's just a line. Like, where's the point of like, okay, I need to get my shit together, you know, have a hoe phase, do whatever you need to do. But like, where's the point of like, you're affecting other people and like there, you know, there's a line, and like she crossed it. And she obviously crossed it with the things that she said, but maybe just in her personal life, she also crossed those boundaries for herself.
Yeah. And also like after a breakup as well, like people go out and do these things. They drink, they get blacked out. They do what they can to kind of cope with the pain. And unfortunately, some people don't know when to stop and they fall into a rabbit hole and they don't know how to get out. I feel like that's the unfortunate case in this instance, you know. You can only want to, how do I say this? She has to want to help herself. You know, you can lead a horse to the water, but you can't make it drink.
True. I completely agree with that. It would have been nice if she had done that before this all blew up, you know, but now that it is, it's kind of like, well, how much is it because she got caught, and how much is it within her to be like, oh, wow, like this is completely blatantly not okay. I need to do something about it. I mean, it's probably a little bit of both, to be quite honest.
Right. And I thought that at first, I was like, hey, like, you know, you're not sorry because you did it, because if no one would have called you out, it would have been a continuous thing. You're sorry because you got caught.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, that's the way it is. And sometimes it takes someone calling someone out for them to realize, hey, maybe I am being a jackass, or maybe I am being an asshole and I need to calm down, or I need to do what I need to do to get help for me. And some people do need that self-realization reality check, or else they'll never change. Sure. And I feel like this was really an eye-opener for her, not only because me calling her out individually, texting her, telling her, hey, this is not okay, like that's a blatantly racist word, but me putting it out there for everyone else to see. Again, I didn't want to do it, but she needs to change. It's unfair to everyone around her.
I mean, there are obviously levels to racism, and like it calls into question the people who say, I'm not racist, but, right? Like, oh, I'm not racist because I have friends that are persons of color. I have this, I've dated women that are Black, like all of these things, or like I have family members who are Black, like all of this stuff. And it's like, but you can still be racist because there's levels to it. Like, even if you would never do something or say something, there are things that are so ingrained because of systematic racism and white supremacy. It's levels, and you have to sift through these levels. It's a process. So to just say that you're not racist, it's not enough, especially with all of, even if she didn't have any of that evidence and those things that she did, like just saying that, it just shows entitlement and shows white privilege. Cause it's like, you can still be racist and you've dated people that of color. You can still, like, it doesn't absolve you. And I think that, like, when I had seen her tweets about, you know, where she had used, it wasn't the hard ER, but even just using that, it's someone else's culture. You're appropriating a culture who's been oppressed. It's hard. And I think that's why people are having such a hard time with it. And that's why I don't think there were a lot of people that didn't like her before this, because of that entitlement and that privilege.
Well, you would think if she has dated people that are of color and has family members that are mixed, like she says, even has friends that are Black or mixed or whatever they might be of color, that she would have more respect towards that word and not just throw it around. That's kind of what upset me, is that she kept saying, I'm not racist, I'm not racist. But how can you repeatedly say the hard N-E-R word around me if you're not racist? It doesn't make sense. And if you cared about my feelings, then you wouldn't have even said it in the first place.
My heart goes out to those fans that had admired her for so long that are people of color and also queer. And to have a role model blatantly disrespect your culture is, I can't imagine how triggering that must be. I mean, it's triggering for me just to be in the gay community and have those slurs of the gay community against me. It's a personal attack. But to have someone do that for, you know, just for something that you can't control and somebody that you look up to, I feel for those young impressionable, even if they're not impressionable, just like the disappointment of having someone of that status do that, especially in this climate, always, but especially in this climate right now, there is no excuse.
I'm sure she has some colored followers who are younger, 15, 16 years old, that are like, oh my gosh, this Michele Lundy girl is like my idol. Like, I look up to her. She influences me. And now you have this girl that is supposed to be influencing these young girls or these young boys, throwing around racist terms. How does that look? It's kind of disappointing, to be honest.
And I think it's also something to be talked about, just about idolizing, like, and I wouldn't consider myself a religious person, but, you know, idolizing false, I forget what the commandment is, but when you idolize like false idols and things like that, and in admiring these people and putting them on this pedestal when they didn't really do much to earn that pedestal, and they're continually not doing what they're supposed to do for the community, it's detrimental to young, you know, gay people that are looking up to someone and they're seeing this person doing these different things and then maybe excusing them. I'm sure she has loyal followers, and I've seen that where they're excusing her behavior and like, oh, she's not like that. Oh, this stuff, this and that. It's detrimental for the community, because I just feel like young people in general are very impressionable, but you have young gay people who are in the closet dealing with a lot of trauma. There's so much to coming out. And then they have this person that they put a lot of their hopes and dreams, and they look forward to them to entertain them going through things. And to put these people on a pedestal similar to big time celebrities, right? Like, they're just people, and they have different backgrounds, and they have ignorance, and they have their journey and their process. You know, she's going through things, obviously, like everybody else. But instead of, you know, using that to help people, which hopefully she can do in the future, she's using it for personal gain, selfish gain. And I don't know if she's in a place to be, she isn't in a place to be a person.
A public figure.
No.
And that's the thing. It would be different if she had like 4,000 or 5,000 followers and they would like brush it off, you know. But when you have 300,000 people following you, and it's not just people from the US, it's not just people from here. I had people from Australia messaging me. That's huge.
Yeah.
That's huge. When you come from a small town in Florida and people in Australia know who you are, do better. Yeah. That's all. Do better.
I completely agree. What's your take on cancel culture? Because there, I feel like there are two sides to this that's happening. You have the people that are like bringing to light, like what you've done, like this is what's happening. This isn't okay. Bringing it to light. But then you have these people that are the cancel culture mob mentality that are coming at her and just saying like mean, they're just being mean. It's not constructive criticism. It's mean. It's just hopping on the bandwagon of like, you know, punching her down. Like, what are your thoughts on that?
Part of me is like, okay, well, this person fucked up. Like, it's not okay for people to bully her. And like, people said that things I was posting was bullying, but they really weren't. It was just stated facts of things she said to me. It was honest truth. You know, like people were bringing things out the light from years ago, things that she said 5, 6, 7 years ago, which also had obtained to the racist subject. Now, also, that isn't bullying either, because it's things she has written on paper and put out for the internet to see.
Yeah.
Now, I can understand, like, people making fun of, like, her relationship and, I guess, the new girl she's been dating and, like, pictures going around. Like, that's not okay with me. I think that's, like, downright mean. Her personal life right now and what she does on the side of everything that's happening is no one's business, you know? Mm-hmm. But I think the fact that she is a public figure and all her skeletons are coming out of the closet, and it really is sad. It sucks. But when one skeleton falls out, it isn't just one. It's a whole bunch of them. It's Halloween in this bitch.
The ghosts are coming out. The ghouls. Like, people don't fuck around when this shit comes out. No. But yeah, I agree with you.
Yeah, I don't think they should be, like, canceling her. Again, she's human, and she makes mistakes, and if she can come back and prove to everyone, hey, like, I fucked up, and she can genuinely admit that she fucked up, and she can prove to these people that follow her, the 300,000 people that follow her, that she's getting the help she needs, and that she's trying to change, and that she's genuinely sorry for the things she's done, I'm 100%, 99% sure people will take her back, because they'll realize she's trying to change, and she's only a person. Just like the rest of us, but she's put on a pedestal because of her social public figure and platform.
Yep. I agree with you. I definitely think that she has room for redemption. I think that she has to put in the work. I think she has to, you know, recognize her shortcomings, get help for the things that she's dealing with right now. And that could be a huge help for the community. Like, hey, I'm going through this and I had a bad time and now I'm doing better. I mean, she could really turn this around to be better than what she did before, but she has to put in the work and rebuild. And that's something that's going to be really hard because of all of the hate and everything that's happened. And it's going to be really hard. So I'm interested to see if she uses it do her best. And like, I kind of think about it in like, you know, the whole Logan Paul situation, which obviously that was a bigger scale because he's a bigger celebrity, but like he did something that was so bad and it was just global, like universal bad. And he took time and I think that he rebuilt himself and I think he's better because of it. And I feel like she could do the same, obviously on a smaller scale with her influence.
Yeah. And the thing she's done is fucked up, you know, like she should know better.
Yeah.
But not everyone is raised with those morals of doing good.
Yeah.
And genuinely, it's not all her fault. Maybe she's just misguided and misled. I think the things that she has done is inexcusable, but I don't think that it's unforgivable. I think that she can come back from this and be a better person and use her platform for good rather than the things she's been using it for.
Yeah, I definitely agree. And I hope that she can do that. And it seems like she is a good person, you know, if she, you know, when she's not drinking, when she's sober, and hopefully that comes to light. I definitely want, I mean, everyone wants a happy ending. Like, I definitely want her to have that, but she's going to need to earn it. And it's going to take a long time to rebuild that.
I agree. And I hope she doesn't lose herself completely, you know, like I really hope that she does get the help that she needs. And I hope she comes back from this because, as I told her before, you have a lot of followers, but social media isn't everything. If you lost your whole social media, who would you be tomorrow? No one would see you except for the people that see you every day in Florida. Without social media, I mean, honestly, like, it's rough to say this, but you're just like the rest of us.
Yeah.
You're a nobody without that shit.
When the camera's turned off, who are you? You know? And everyone has their own journey. And everyone has, I think at some point, an identity crisis or a loss of identity. I've definitely had that a few times. And it is like, who are you without the praise and the admiration and the clout and the influence and the crazy chaotic shit and the drama? Like at your core, when you're waking up in the morning or taking a shit, like who the fuck are you? If you don't know.
Or changing your tampon, you know, the basic shit.
Those human things, you got to know who you are. And it could take time. And I think that clout and things can get to people's heads. And I wonder, like, do you know who she was before all of this? Because, like, I did not know when I saw her on TikTok, maybe because I'm, like, I don't know, in my mid-20s, I didn't know. And I didn't come out until 3 years later. But, like, I didn't know she was big on Instagram before TikTok. I saw her on TikTok and I was like, oh, damn, like, look at her. How did she get this clout?
I've followed her for probably 4 or 5 years, and even then she still had 100,000 followers. And me and my friend, I'm actually from Virginia, so I didn't even know her living in Florida. Okay. We like found her on Instagram. I guess she blew up somehow and someone tagged her, and me and my friend followed her, and we used to follow all her drama with like Whitney and Shay, and like every week there would be like updates, and we're like, oh my God, what's going on with Wendy's life this week? Like, and it's funny because like everyone refers to her as Lundy, but the people actually know her, she's called by Michelle. So it's funny to have known this girl for the past 5 years as Lundy and then finally meet her in person and be like, yo, Michelle, like, this is not okay. It's so crazy because I followed her for so long. And I don't know where the clout really came from. I think it was from the whole weight loss thing she put out. And then from there, it just blew up. People are like, wow, look how much weight this girl has lost. And look at her now. And like, look how good she looks. And then it turned into, oh, well, she has a relationship. She's gay. Like, oh my gosh, who's she dating? Look at this drama. She cheated. What happened? Like, just it's all blown up out of proportion over time. And I feel like she has this clout and this platform from nothing. What, she didn't do something good. She didn't save the world. She didn't donate hundreds of thousands of dollars to the Cancer Society. She's just like the rest of us on a fucking silver plate.
I mean, if she posted stuff about her weight loss, like that must have been a super vulnerable thing to do. And like, obviously body image is such a huge issue with women. Just doesn't matter if you're gay or straight, like it's a huge thing brought on by society. So like to be able to like document that and show that is an extremely vulnerable thing. So I feel like at some point she was looking for connection and being like, hey, I want to show my weight loss. Maybe this will help other people. Because like, why would you put yourself out there like that if you didn't? So I feel like at some point there was some good intentions with it and very organic, like, hey, I'm going to put this out there. And then at some point along the way, it got to her head.
Yeah. I honestly like didn't know how she was until the first time I ever met her, probably again, like 4 months ago. Had only seen her from social media, known about her from all the drama with the exes. And I actually saw her at a party and she walks past me and then keeps walking and then turns back around and stops right in front of me, looks me up and down. And I just kind of look at her like, oh, what's going on? You know, she looks at me and goes, wow, you're good looking. Good for you. And then walks away. And I'm like, who the fuck does this bitch think she is? Like, hella weird. But after that, I kind of like being around her more, saw that that was her humor. And she is funny, but there's just some shit she needs to change for the better. Just like all of us, you know, we all can't be perfect. But again, when you're sitting on a platform, there's certain shit you can't do that the rest of us can do and get away with it.
Yeah, true. And I feel like it's so interesting because like I did see people, you know, bringing up her old tweets and things like that. And it's such a fine line because like you have these people like, you know, that, you know, Kevin Hart, when he would got blasted for shit that he said 10 years ago, I think it was about the gay community. I don't remember. But like, you have all these people that get this and there's a one point where it's like, okay, when is it cancel culture? And when is it holding accountability? and when is it too much? Because I felt like if you said something like, I was 15, 10 years ago, like I was a fucking piece of shit, like not a piece of shit, but like I was ignorant and dumb. And like, if people held me to those actions that happened when I was 15, like I'm a different person now. So like,
right.
I think there, if it's continuous, obviously like with Lundy, like it shows a pattern of behavior. So like it's proof that shows a pattern of behavior because it's still happening currently. But if it's something like, I don't know if you agree, you can just choose to disagree with me and that's fine. But like with Jenna Marbles, like when she did blackface, which totally unacceptable, but it was something that got brought up 10 years ago. She said like, hey, I'm done. I'm not doing stuff anymore. And I saw a lot of people that were in the black community that were like, dude, it's fine. Like, we've forgiven you. Like, it's okay. Like, all of this stuff. So I like, where is the line of like holding people accountable and then just like digging up shit and not taking into account that like they've grown and changed as people?
So like, I agree. When I was 15, I was a piece of shit too. I mean, 15, 16, 17 years old, I was going out drinking, blacking out on sidewalks, throwing up. Like,
yeah,
everyone went through those phases, you know. It's just, it's how you grow. But I feel like people are pulling it out the woodworks of all these things she's done because they're genuinely, if she would have grown up and changed her ways and not been how she's being recently, all that shit would have stayed in the fucking closet.
Yeah.
But it's the fact that she now is putting blatantly racist terms out there to people around her and people are fed up with her shit.
Yeah.
If she would have been a good ass person and done good things for the community as a public figure, as a being on a platform, people might have been like, okay, well, let's brush this under the rug because she is a good person. She made mistakes in the past. But they see how she's acting every day and how reckless she is with the things she says, and it's just one thing after another. And finally, when that can of worms was open, they all fucking spilled all over the floor.
Yeah.
Hot, soggy fucking worms, like
crawling out to eat her dead carcass.
Yeah, dude, like it's unbelievable.
I agree with you there. If there's like a pattern of behavior there, then I think that, you know, her stuff being unearthed, like I think it's proof. It's not bullying. What you did was not bullying at all. And what that those proof, it's not bullying. It's showing pattern of behavior. I think that if she had changed and was for the better now, and people were trying to unearth that, first of all, it wouldn't get any traction. And second of all, I think it would just, it would be like, you're not taking into account the fact that somebody grows and changes and has an upbringing and is actively trying to rid themselves of whatever the shit that has been put in their brains.
At this point, like, I did delete those other ones. I just kept that post up to mainly show the point I was trying to get to. And that's the only thing I've kept up. All the other Lundy's Dundy, cancel Lundy, all that shit, people are still posting about every day. And I just kind of ignore it. And like, I haven't made any like fake pages about it or anything. I just stuck to the topic and the point I was trying to get to. And then I moved on with my day. Whatever social media did, they took it upon themselves.
Yeah, the Lundy's Dundy stuff, I mean, it is kind of, it's kind of funny because of like, it just the word itself is just like, damn, people are creative. But it is part of cancel culture. If you're using that hashtag and that's hopping on cancel culture. If you're being mean, like I made a post because I saw everybody making a post and I was like, okay, I need to speak on this. And it was just, you know, hey, educate yourself. This is not to be tolerated. And I had people that were like, thank you so much for posting this. I didn't know what was happening. Hey, what's happening and stuff like that. So like raising awareness, but I had comments that people were just being mean. And I did not respond at all. And then other people were like, hey, that's not okay. We're not doing this. Cause there's a line and people are so ready, like mob mentality. Humans just love that shit. And especially when it's anonymous and you have user 232142, that's like, you know, blah, 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 ugly, whatever, you know? And you're just like, seriously, man, like, come on.
Yeah. People coming out the woodworks to put in their input. Definitely.
Everybody has an opinion.
Yeah, that's for sure.
And I think that's the thing too. And this time, especially just being so politically polarizing, everything is so polarizing. Everyone has an opinion and it's not esteemed to have an opinion. You can have an opinion about anything and you don't have to have proof. You can just blah, 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 Trump for president, blah, and you don't have to actually have anything behind it. And I think it's more important to have empathy. And that's why holding people accountable but not being a part of cancel culture is so crucial, because you can still have empathy for Michelle, even though what she did was obviously uncalled for and she needs to be reprimanded. You can, like, you know, what you had said before, like, you can't call into question just her, like, what's her upbringing like, what things is she dealing with right now? Like, that takes empathy to be like, hey, what you did was uncalled for, but also you're a human being and, like, I hope you get out of this, but I also hope that, like, you learn and maybe struggle, like, a little bit, but then, like, be okay in the end.
Yeah, and I don't think it should be taken to the point of, like, her being bullied so bad that she hurts herself. She definitely needs to open her eyes to the way she's treated people and the way people are being treated by her and how people feel about it, because no one really wanted to speak out about it before, and I feel like it's because she does have the figure that she has and people were scared. Yeah. But I'm an outsider. I've known her for 3 months and I was tired of the shit. She had to be called out on it or else it was never going to change. And I didn't mean for the whole fucking world to put their input in, but it's just like Lay's, like, you can't just eat one. Like, as soon as it's fucking out there, that's it.
The whole bag of Lay's has been eaten.
Yeah.
What do you think about the account that's putting all of that proof out there? I think it's called Lundy Exposed or Exposing Lundy. What are your thoughts on that?
I have nothing to do with that. Like, I saw that and someone actually sent me the page and was like, hey, is this your account? And I was like, absolutely not. Like,
yeah,
if I'm going to put something out there, it's going to be on my own account. Like, I have been.
Yeah.
I'm not with that fake shit. Like, I'm not trying to fucking scam you. Like, if I have something to say, it's going to come fucking directly from the source. Yeah. Like, it's not going anywhere else. That person must know her. And it really must be someone within her friend group. Oh, and I, like, stand behind that, because who the fuck else knows all that shit about her? No one from Instagram knows everything about Michele. One of her friends that's tired of her shit as well, that doesn't want her name to be put out there, that's exposing her the quiet way.
Damn. I just thought it was, like, someone who had had enough and, like, it got enough traction to where people were just, like, everyone from who had a little bit of information was who had proof was like sending it, but that makes more sense. Whew, like a mole.
Because this person knows everything. And again, some of that stuff on there is not stuff that people that don't know her could even send in. It's people that know her personally and just tired of her shit. And they want to be anonymous, but they also want things to be brought to light. It sucks. It's the way it is.
Oh. Oh my God.
And that's,
oh, she got a fucking
thesis.
Mole. She's got a fucking mole. Damn.
So
that's,
yeah,
nuts.
lots of fucking piping hot tea here. Would you like some honey?
I love some. Do you agree with the things that are being posted on there? Like, do you agree how the account is going about?
No, I think it should come to an end. What has needed to be said has been said, and I think that it's just being dragged along now. She said what she had to say.
Yeah,
everyone else said what they had to say. Leave it alone now. I mean, I know it's not going to go away that fast of the racist shit she said, but stop pulling shit out the fucking woodworks. Like, that shit doesn't need to be posted every day. Like, she's a person with feelings too, and she has a life, and people are taking it beyond and over what it needs to be.
I think that it's because it's trending, that it's no longer about. Similarly to anything that happens that's trends, and it gets to a point where, like, a trend is necessary to build awareness, but then it just becomes something of a fad and it takes away from the real meaning of what's happening. And so I think that it's getting into that where it's just trending and it's not about the facts and it's not about the education and it's not it's not about the movement. It's not about the substance anymore. And we're getting into that now.
Right. Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I really don't have anything else to say about the matter of subject. I basically told you everything that's on my mind about it. I think that she just needs to change. I hope she gets help. I really hope that she starts using her public figure and her platform for the better, because I want to see her do well, and a lot of people want to see her do well. So she needs to do better.
Yep. I think you have those people that always just want to see people on top fail, but you also have people that, you know, more educated people like you and I who are like, you know what, we want to see everyone do well and educate themselves and be on that journey to self-development and self-growth and be better. And I feel like she can be better. And I want her to be better, not just for herself, but for all of the influence that she has over these people, because if she can do that growth, then it's going to help and just trickle down onto that influence. And who wouldn't want that?
Yeah, exactly. I agree.
Oh, well, yeah, that was a lot. That was awesome. How has this been for you personally with, I mean, just your family? You come from an interracial family and you're mixed. How did the coming of light and this side of stuff kind of end for you?
Parts of it, you know, obviously touched me, because the parts of it that made me angry was thinking about my family more than myself. I have a sister. She's mixed as well. I have a little brother and I have an older brother. And I obviously have family on my dad's side. My dad's side's Black. My little brother is obviously mixed. Coming from all this that has been happening with the BLM movement and all this shit that's been going on makes me upset, because it's like, I have a little brother that's of skin color. If he gets pulled over for any reason, such as even a tail light out, I don't know what's going to happen to him. It's kind of sad that in this day and age, we have to discuss with little kids, 14, 15, 16 years old, hey, if a cop tells you to do something, fucking do it, because if not, you're going to lose your life.
Yeah.
That's really fucked up, and that's super fucking sad that those things have to be reiterated all the time. Not only my little brother, but I have cousins that are Black. I have uncles. I have nephews, nieces. It's just despicable, the shit that's happening. And me, myself, obviously, I want to go into law enforcement. I start the academy soon. So it's kind of hard for me to look at it from both sides, because there also is police officers losing their lives every day for no reason. Mm-hmm. You have these riots, people fucking burning shit down, people throwing shit at police officers, breaking windows. That's not okay either. So this is a hard topic to talk about, honestly, because it plays a role on both sides. I don't fully stand with Blue Lives Matter. I also don't fully stand with All Lives Matter. It's hard. I can't really speak much about that.
Yeah, it's a complicated issue. And like with the rioters, I mean, you have your people who are protesting, but then you have people that are coming out that are just wanting to be anarchists and just will find any reason to just burn shit to the ground and in the name of whatever protest is happening. So like, I think it's good to separate those two. Like, you have the protesters who are doing the work for the movement, but then you have these people that are coming out just to fucking, like, you know, throw shit and get crazy, you know, just have that anonymity of just, you know, like people on the internet bullying and stuff, that anonymity, like the permission to do things. So yeah, I definitely see why it is super complicated to have those opinions.
So that's a topic I can't really touch much about, because it's like playing both sides of the fucking spectrum.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I totally get that. Yeah, is there anything else that you want to talk about?
Yeah, so the LGBT community, being that it is so small, we all need to kind of have each other's backs and stand for each other rather than try to pull each other down, because in reality, we're all we have. Mm-hmm. LGBT community runs many diversities, Black, white, Spanish, Asian, so on and so forth. We need to stand for each other, because if we don't, no one will. In reality, being gay, being trans, being bi, being queer is a minority group. We are all minorities. No matter your color, you're the group that stands out and the group that has to get votes for to have legal marriage and, you know, so on and so forth. And it sucks to say that, but it's not widely accepted everywhere. So we need to do what we need to do to keep growing as a community, because if we tear each other down, we're going to have nothing.
I completely agree. We need to come together. I think the LGBTQ community is very loyal and very banded, and they are like that for a reason. You know, you have these loyal people that are looking and striving for connection on social media, and it's for a reason, right? There's not a lot of us, maybe 10%, right, of the population, and nobody is, you're right, nobody's going to fight for us. We have to fight for ourselves, and that includes everyone in the community, because it is intersectional.
Yeah. And coming from Virginia, being such a conservative state, it was hard for me growing up. It wasn't accepted at all around here. I kind of felt like I had to dress a certain way or act a certain way around people because it wasn't accepted or people would look at me funny. I can say that moving to Florida and meeting the friend group that I did opened me up to being me, to being free. I learned how to express myself in ways that I could have never learned living in Virginia. And I really do thank the gay community in Florida for that. And it makes me happy to say that I do live in Florida and I will never live anywhere else because it is so widely accepted there. People make you feel a part of something.
Yeah, I love that. I also grew up in a conservative Republican family in Ohio, the swing state. So yeah, it was definitely kind of about the same experience as you and in having to move downtown because I was living in the country and moving downtown, being able to be around more of a queer community and finding queer friends. It makes all the difference. It makes you, not that I'm saying that other people can make you more of who you are, but like it makes you realize more of who you are when you're around people who are truly being themselves, even if it's online or in person. It affects growth immensely.
I agree.
Thank you so much for being on this podcast, Gabi. If you want to check out more about her, you can find her on Instagram at Gabitron. You have like a few A's in there. I want to make sure that I put
you
right.
Yes, it's at GABBAATRONN.
Okay. Well, you can find her there. And then you also, did I say your TikTok right too?
I don't even know my TikTok. I don't post that much.
Okay.
Main thing is Instagram.
No problem. Yeah. So, if you want to find more about her, check that out. As always, you can find me on all platforms at Bree Logan. If you enjoyed this episode, please drop us a rating on Apple Podcasts. Help us get discovered by more queer people just like you. That's it for this episode, my queers. Thank you for listening and subscribing. If you're not subscribed to Apple Podcasts, hit that subscribe button and give us a follow on Spotify. And if you love this episode, like I said, drop us a rating. Be you, be queer, stay safe. And we will see you on the next episode.